Hello and welcome to the example one. So let's raise and catch an exception. So you'll understand how to raise and catch exception and how to define a structure to catch those exceptions. Okay, so let's do an exercise on that and understand the concept. So if you go to example one, logical flow, we will raise and catch a divide by zero error, which is a very common error. If you divide anything by zero, you will get an error. So we'll try to raise that error and then we'll try to catch it. Part of it, we'll try to create this file, control N, control S, and I'll create a new folder under www and I'll call it as exceptions. Okay, and I'll save the file inside this folder. So how to write a structure to catch the error? Okay, so for that you have something called as try keyword. The try keyword is basically whatever you write inside this, it will try to monitor for errors. Okay, and if there are any errors in this block, it will try to catch using a catch keyword. Okay, again, catch is basically another block. So if there is an error in the try block, means there is an error in this block, it will jump to this block if try block has an error. Okay, this jumping of try to catch block is automatically taken care from the PHP. You don't have to worry about go to and put a label and move around the program. Automatically, when there is an issue in this try block, the PHP will automatically jump to the catch block and start executing the code in the catch block. Okay, so that's the syntax for how do you write a try catch block. Using a try catch block, you will try to raise an exception in the try block and you will catch the exception in the catch block. And for the catch keyword, you have to pass in the argument of name of the exception. So name of the exception is exception, and you'll create a variable for it. Okay, so this is the very generic syntax of how to write a try catch block, using which you can catch the error and then you will decide to do what to do with an error. Okay, for that you have to raise an error first. So we will write a function to raise an error and then we'll try to define it in the try block and we'll see whether the catch block gets executed or not. So we are able to successfully catch that error or not. If you are not catching the error, then it will error out into the console, right? If you catch it, then it is successfully comes out of the program. Okay, we're gonna see all those details now, but first we will write that function. So I'll use a divide function and we will return a type integer and we will pass parameter like divide x and y. Okay, and we'll say if dollar y is less than equal to 0, then you know this will cause an error when you divide x by y. Okay, if it is not, then you are saying result is equal to dollar x divided by dollar y. Okay, if dollar y is 0, anything divided by 0 will raise an error. Okay, that's why we are checking it here. We'll do something about it. So now we are safe to do that divide operation and we will return the result now. Okay, so how to raise an error? Okay, how to throw an error? So for that you have a keyword called throw and you have to create an object of exception by passing up the message. The message is, you will say divide 0 exception might happen. So what we are doing it here is we are trying to identify the case where it will might happen the error, and then if it is less than equal to 0, you are trying to throw an exception. And when you throw this exception, where it has been catch? It is catch in the try catch block where it has been called. Okay, so if you say result is equal to divide and we'll pass 1, 0, right? And then in the catch block we are saying echo we have catch the exception here, we'll get the message and we'll say PHP end of line. Okay, so we have done couple of things here. We are checking whether the value is less than equal to 0. If it is less than equal to 0, we are throwing an exception. This is how you throw an exception with throw keyword, and you say new and create an instance of exception by passing your own custom message. And once this is an error, you're passing 0, so this will be an error, then the catch block get executed, and in the catch block you are actually printing up the message, right? So let's run this program and see whether we are able to catch the exception or not. So let's go to our folder that we created, exceptions, and then we'll run our program. Okay, so it says we have caught the exception, that's basically your custom message, and divide by zero exception might happen, that's basically your custom message. Okay, and imagine we are not doing that, right? We are just printing it outside your try catch block, then you basically see a fatal error. The method is throwing an exception but you're not catching it. Because we are not catching it, the PHP is catching that error and throwing and dumping that error. Okay, and if you want to do a clean exit, what do I mean by clean exit? When you don't want PHP to take control of the exception but you want to take that exception into your hands and try to do a clean exit, then typically you use try catch block. Okay, in the try catch block you try to catch the error and do something about the error that you want to do. Okay, because after the error you can, you know, try your normal process. Okay, and it's completely fine, means it's try to execute the next line of code. But if you do this, okay, you basically having an error here. Okay, and that error is been thrown from your program, so you cannot really continue with your program because there's an error being thrown and it is handled by PHP. Now the PHP doesn't know what to do, so it's dumped everything onto the console and then it stopped the program. Okay, so be careful when you write this kind of code. You need to have a good practice of writing the try catch block, catch the error and then try to handle that error with a clean exit. Okay, well, I hope it's very clear how to write a try catch block, how to raise an error, how to catch an error, okay, and how do you do a clean exit from your program. Okay, so that's all about how to raise and catch exceptions, and I'll see you in the next one.